This is our day, O God, and we are excited to hear what is your word for each and every one of us today, Lord God. For whatever word is that, Lord God, we thank you in advance, Lord God. Because you know, we know that today you will speak right through our hearts, O God.
Our children are in school, we're in our churches, we're in our families, we're in our neighborhoods, we're in organizations, we're in sporting organizations, we're in our community in different ways. How are you showing your light and how are you being salt in these communities? When you think about the properties of light, you think about two things. It gives people the ability to see something. It gives people the ability to see their way. And it also, sunlight provides energy. So we have to think about ourselves in our communities. How are we showing people the way? Some of these people may never walk through the doors of the church. They may never read the Bible. They may never learn about God any other way. But we have an opportunity to show them the goodness of God, show them the light of God, love on them, give them a word of encouragement, be in the mother's circle that's not gossiping, that says something positive about the person they're tearing down. Be in the workforce to be the person that takes the high road and doesn't, you know, praise for their boss instead of, even if he's a bad one, because no one can deal with him better than God. We have, you know, or the child that's unruly, that may be bullying your children, to hug that child, to love that child, to be different. And it's a challenge, because I'm a mother, and I'm mama bear. Someone messes with my child, I'm ready to storm the Capitol, you know, go up to school and burn everything down. How dare you! You know, but WWJD, I'm gonna bring the dust off of that. What would Jesus do? You have to take a few breaths. So we have to be the light. So turn to your neighbor and say, girl, shine bright.
Girl, shine bright.
See, I can't let y'all talk. That's my And then you'll get to explain it one day, or they'll realize that what that difference is that it's Him living in you. Flavor changes things. It's how are we changing the environment for the better? Not just to exist, but to truly, truly make an impact on someone's life. We should enter our communities with the thought of how can I make a difference? We're not supposed to hide it. And it may be on a huge platform with a lot of people, or it may be to the person right next to you. The lady that you're like, can I come over and help you? Let me help you up the steps, or you know, let me help you carry your groceries or whatever, just whatever. But you have a gift, whether it's compassion, whether it's love, whatever that is, use it for His glory. I had to call Him the Good Samaritan. I feel like the Good Samaritan in Luke 10 in our communities, when we see something, when we see an opportunity, you will know to act and act quickly, like the Good Samaritan, to be there in a time of need. You'll be like, this is my time. This is where I'm supposed to. And my answer to you is to stay connected to your community. As we are in the community, we are wells that people are drawing from. We have to stay here where we know that people are gonna, where the Lord lives in our praises, where we can come to a breakfast, where we can sing, where we can be filled, where we can hear God's word. There, and if you don't come to church, I mean, right now we can't come together as a congregation, but there's Zoom calls every Sunday. Pastor Brad has been going over really tremendous messages on the heart of David and on David's life. There's small groups that you can get on. There's women's studies that you can get in. You can encourage your husband to be in men's studies, because we got to keep our husbands and our brothers and our sons strengthened as well. Stay connected to your community, because it's going to help you stay full and
accepting at work without compromising your faith. This is for us, so Christian women working outside. It's really a battle in the workplace. Actually, pardon me if I would get emotional, because as I was preparing this, I was really having a hard time. I said, Lord, I know what to say, but I just don't know how and what. That's what I expected. Not a single positive word. Not a single positive word. I was like a grapes crush. I remember the song, Crush, Persecuted, but Not Abandoned. And I said, Lord, how can I speak for this if my spirit is crushed? These are the words that they said. Kathy, you've been a pioneer of the school. This is your third year. You just didn't meet the expectation. And it was funny because in my mind, wow. In my mind, I was thinking, really? Seriously? I was thinking like that. And I was like, we've given you a lot of trainings, expensive trainings from the IBs. Seems like you didn't meet the expectation.
Stand in front and be a testimony. I was like, Lord, why did you allow these things to happen? I need your strength to speak for tomorrow, but why? Why did you crush my spirit? I don't know how to testify.
Behold, I send you out as a sheep in the midst of wolves. So be wise as serpents and innocent as doves. Workplace is a battle for every one of us. Raise your hand, those working women like me. It's a battle. And even leaders sometimes became the wolves. But praise God. You cannot even use one single sentence without two. And then I remember when I told my colleagues, can you not just talk, please, without cursing? And then my colleague told me, oh, I'm sorry, Kathy, I know you're a Christian and you believe in Jesus Christ. I know, but you know, we just have to talk the nice way. Don't say this food sentence. Okay, Kathy, when we are in front of you, we're not going to say those nice things. You know, sometimes when people are talking to you, you're just playing in my mind. I was imagining standing up. You don't have the right to say that to me.
I was feeling so down. Said, Kathy, stop being dramatic. You're a son of, you're a daughter of God.
You are a human being. You know, I didn't realize. But
you know, as I leave the room, I told like, Miss Mo, thank you, Miss Lu, thank you, God bless you. I was like, God bless you.
The way we act reflects our faith. So sometimes during Sundays and Bible study days, they're very good.
But during those days that we are not around with God, it's like, who the dude are you? You should just be double characters, you know. Away, no one's gonna take me away from this place, only God. And then they don't, you can tell to yourself, but don't tell them. They don't have the right to tell me that I'm nothing, I'm not good enough. Because in the eyes of God, I am good. I am the daughter of the most man, of the King of Kings. Never boast. Well, I think there are times really, like, especially if you've been in the workplace for how many years and you're used to it, sometimes you tend to boast yourself. But we always have to be reminded about Jesus, that Jesus is the Son of God, but he came to serve and not to serve. Yeah, I pray and thank the Lord because my husband is very helpful to me. He knows I'm tired, so after dinner, he washed the dishes.
And served God's purpose in his own generation, he fell asleep. He was buried with his ancestors and his body decayed. Our bodies decay, we go to sleep, but that's what would have been his ash. And as a teenager, that scripture really spoke to me. He served the purpose of God in his generation. And I determined as a teenager that was going to be mine.
I don't know if we were writing with it earlier on. It's not kind of...
Okay, that's not what the pencil's for. If we misuse it, it's going to be abusive or it's going to cause damage. But if our lives are on God's hand, then we are going to serve his purpose. Michelangelo was asked, like, how he thought of all these amazing statues that he made. And he said that I saw the angel in the marble and I simply carved him out of it.
Yes.
And God sees us. He sees his purpose for us. But can we see that? Can we see the angel or the masterpiece that God is wanting to create out of us? All of us have an overarching sense of purpose, even from young. I remember when I heard the sermon on purpose when I was a teenager, the pastor said, write down these words, and you can write them down if you want. He said, write down my purpose in life is, and then fill in the words. And I remember I was about 15, 16, and I wrote, my purpose, or God's purpose for my life is, or my purpose in life is, and I wrote these words, to touch people's lives with God's loving kindness. And whether you're young, you can still know God's purpose. And single, whether you've got little babies, you can still know God's purpose. And now here I am in China, still knowing God's purpose.
Okay, so how should we go? Should we go like the, you know, from the shortest and tallest, my shortest and tallest. I'm going to start with you, Kathy.
I love you.
I love you too. So thank you so much, Kathy.
Thank you.
Yay. Love you.
Okay.